Welcome everyone to the lecture on Introduction to Spreadsheets. I am S. Srinivas, a co-instructor at the IIT Madras online BSc degree program. We are going to look at two spreadsheet applications, one Microsoft Excel and two Google Sheets. We will first look at Microsoft Excel and just type in Excel. And the application will open. We create a blank workbook, and this is how a spreadsheet looks. So you have the rows, you have the columns, and each of these is called a cell. This is cell A1, this is B1, this is C1, and so on. And this is the formula bar, right? So we then look at Google Sheets. We type in Google Sheets. Make sure that you're logged in when you access Google Sheets. And we go to personal. And this is how a Google Sheet will look like. We click blank here and a blank sheet is created. This is how a blank Google Sheet will look like. We can name this sheet as test, for example. And there are many operations which can be performed on Google Sheets and Microsoft Excel. So we'll try doing some basic operations initially and see how it works. Say we want to compare or add the marks of two students. I have student 1 here and student 2 here. So in cell A1 there is student 1 and in B1 there is student 2. So there are different operations which can be performed, but first we will fill in the marks of students in three different subjects. Say they have scored 65, 65 and 45 and 34, 76 and 45. So now I can find the sum of students 1 and 2 in subject 1. That is done by doing an equal to and go to that particular cell which needs to be added. This is A2 in this case, plus cell B2. Turns out that the sum of students 1 and 2 in a certain subject is 99. Excel has an interesting feature that if you drag this cell to the other cells, it just performs the operation for the other cell. So what you see here is cell A3 plus cell B3. And similarly, here we have cell A4 plus B4. Right? The same operation can be also performed in Google Sheets. So we have student 1 and student 2. So I randomly type in certain numbers. And we can again do the same operations as we did in Microsoft Excel. So we have A2 equal to A2 plus B2, and this will give us the sum. And this asks you whether an autofill can be performed. We say yes. Or even otherwise, you can just drag it, and that particular formula is extended to other cells. So it is A3 plus B3, A4 plus B4, and so on. Now we go back to Microsoft Excel and see if we can perform a subtraction. Say I want to perform a subtraction on A2 minus B2. And as you can see, 65 minus 34 is 31, and that is again performed. And 65 minus 76 is minus 11. This was just dragged down and the operations were extended. Similarly, Google Sheets also has that capability. So I do an A2 minus B2 and again task for autofill, and the operations have been extended. And there are various other commands to look at the sum. For example, equal to A2 plus B2 is not the only way. For example, you could have done a sum of 56 and 34 by this. So A2 till B2. So there is a colon in between. So from cells A2 till B2, we perform the sum, and the sum remains the same. And again, you extend it, and the answer will be the same as before. And the same operation again can be performed on a Microsoft Excel. So you perform sum A2 plus B2, and you have the same solution anyway, and you can drag it. And to perform other operations such as multiplication and division, what we do is very straightforward. So if I want to do an A2 by B2, you can do it this way as well. A2 by B2 is a certain value, or if you want to multiply these two numbers, A2 into B2 is also quite possible. So these are the basic operations which can be performed in Excel. And you could use the drag feature to drag the same formula to other cells. The next thing which is very interesting with Excel is that the copy feature, right? So I have certain formulas here, and say I want to copy these formulas to a different cell or copy these values. So when I do that and I go to cell G2 and do that, what happens is the following. It gets extended to that particular cell. So what we had done here is that it is the sum of A2 to B2, that is in cell C2. Now when I move to cell G2, it automatically changes to E2 and F2, right? So for example, if I am copying these cells and putting it in D2, this will become B2 and C2, right? I hope you get this concept. So we initially have A2 and B2, and the sum of A2 and B2 is provided in cell C2. Now when I copy this formula to D2, it automatically changes to B2 and C2. So as you move along the columns, the values get updated to the next column in this case automatically. And when we go to E2, what will happen is that when I copy the formula here, it will automatically change to C2 and D2. And when I do it to F, it will become D2 and E2, right? So in cell F, it is sum of D2 till E2. And in cell G, it is E2 to F2. So when we copy a certain cell with a formula, it will get copied automatically with the formula itself, and it gets updated depending on the cell which is in a particular row or a particular column. And as you can see here, the rows also get updated. So this is B3 to C3, this is C3 to D3, this is D3 to E3, and so on. So this is what is happening here. Instead, if I wanted to only copy the values, what we can do is we can go to a particular cell and right click, and there is an option to copy values alone, and 99, 141 and 90 are provided here. So there is no formula here, we are just copying down the values. This is most useful because in certain cases we would want the particular values which we obtain from a certain calculation. And we don't want to mess up by adding formulas in the different cells. We only want these three values. In that case, copying and saying paste as values will help. And the same operation can be also performed on Google Sheets. So we have the sums here. So when I copy this and paste it in D2, this will automatically get updated to B2 and C2, right? But I don't want this to happen in certain cases. What do I do then? I right click here, in I come to the cell, do a right click, have paste special, and do paste values only so that the initial values are retained. So these are some of the basic operations which can be performed in Excel. Finally, we will look at how charts can be inserted. So I now go to a new sheet This is how you create a new sheet. Now you have sheet 2. And say we have certain roll numbers and we want to have their marks, or we'll have assignment and the marks in the assignment for a particular student and how it varies. So in assignment 1, there is assignment 2 and there is assignment 3, and the marks are 54, 76 and 45, or 54 for this matter. Now I go to insert and chart. So I have not selected data yet. So what we'll have to do is first select data. So I delete this initially. I select this, go to insert and chart. As you can see, this is a bar chart which is being generated. So in assignment 1, it's got about 56, I think, I'm sure. Yeah, 54. In assignment 2, it's 76. In assignment 3, it is 54. The chart is generated in the following manner. Instead, if we want a line chart, it will look something like this. So the assignment is on the x-axis, the marks is on the y-axis, and we create a chart here. But as you can see, the labels are 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5 and 3, which is not the case. There cannot be an assignment 2.5, right, based on the data. So if we want to change such values, it is indeed possible. So I go to the horizontal axis and say treat labels as text. And when I do that, it changes to 1, 2 and 3, and we don't have the 1.5s and the 2.5s. Because we are only looking at the labels. So this is how you create a chart on Google Sheets. I hope you get this. We have the edit chart option, and there are various ways in which you can customize the chart. And there are various other charts available as well. Bar charts and line charts are not the only options, and you could look at various other charts, then the options are provided here. And in Excel, we similarly create a new sheet by doing this plus. And we have assignment. And you have the marks. There are assignments 1, assignment 2, assignment 3. Marks are 76, 56, and 76. Now I need to create a chart again. I select this, I go to insert. So there is an option to generate the chart. So you can create bar charts in this manner, or you could create tree maps, or you could create line charts and so on. So we will look at one of the charts in this case. Now what I want is a line chart. So in order to do that, I go to this scatter plot, and what I get is this, right? But I want to edit the way in which this is looking. So what we do is I double click here so that the format chart area applies. And the horizontal value or the axis has these options. Now I want to edit the way this looks. So what I did was I went to axis options and the final option here. And I don't want a 0.5 increment. I only have assignments 1, 2 and 3. So I want the increment to be 1, and this to be 0, right? So as you can see here, this gets updated. So in assignment 1, you have scored a certain mark. In assignment 2, you have scored a certain mark. In assignment 3, you have scored a certain mark. So this is how you edit. The other way of doing this is, you could click on this chart, right click, There is a format chart area here. You can perform any changes you want in this manner. So there's a chart area, chart title, horizontal value, horizontal axis, and so on. So we have clicked on access options and made the change here. So is this the only chart which you are interested in? There could be various other charts as well.